today on our cosplay calendar update, we're going to show you how we created our Dune-inspired month with the character God Emperor Leto II, Atreides. Dune is a classic science fiction series. It's one of my favorite science fiction series of all time, hands down. And I love this character so much because he's so weird and so bizarre.
How did somebody become a worm? I don't get it. What is this?
Okay, so Leto is the son of Paul Atreides, who was the Kwisatz Haderach of Dune, and he decided to set humanity on his golden path because he saw its destruction in the future. So to ensure that it didn't do that, he decided to merge with sand trout, which are essentially baby sandworms, into a symbiote skin, which eventually turned him into a sandworm over thousands of years, while he was the god tyrant of the universe, of the known universe. He was the emperor, and everybody did what he said, and it's pretty awesome.
So he became a worm because...
he wanted to save humanity.
Oh.
And you can peel back his face flaps and lick the spice essence in there and go into a crazy trip.
Oh. Well, that's not weird at all.
No. I'm here at Studio ADI with monster maker Tim Martin, sculptor extraordinaire, and we've commissioned him to help us work on our calendar. He is sculpting a maquette of our Lord God Emperor Leto from Dune. We're so excited to have you on board, Tim. This is looking fantastic. Tim is the lead creature creator on Harbinger Down, and he's also worked on such films like AI, Spider-Man, Last Samurai, Apocalypto, just to name a few. Serious business here. All right, we're getting the best. All right, we're getting the best of the best working on our calendar for you. So, Tim, how long have you been sculpting?
I started sculpting when I was 15.
15. What brought you to sculpture?
I started drawing when I was a kid. Mm-hmm. And when I felt I got pretty good at that, I discovered something called Sculpey, which is a really cool product you can get from like any craft store. Mm-hmm. So I started making little monsters and stuff out of that. And then just kind of grew from there. And I ended up coming out into this business when I was in my early 20s. Mm-hmm. And we still use the same stuff that I, you know, played with as a kid. What I'm building this out of is something called wed clay. And this is the same kind of stuff you would make pottery out of. Mm-hmm. So it's the stuff, you know, most people can get anywhere, crafts and art stores. We just turned it into monsters.
So once you're done with the sculpture in wed clay, what's the next step?
Since we're going to shoot it in an environment, and this is wet clay, we don't want it to get destroyed. Mm-hmm. So I'm actually going to mold this out of plaster and turn it into what a lot of like Halloween masks are made out of, which is just a really thick latex. Mm-hmm. So the arms, which are now Sculpey, I'll actually take those off, mold those, turn those into a resin. This will be latex and polyfoam. And if you guys don't know what that is, polyfoam is basically what a Nerf ball is made out of. Mm-hmm. So this would be a lightweight, kind of like really durable toy.
Awesome.
And then I'll paint it up. I can paint on that, and then we'll shoot it. Also, the skull I have in here is just represents the size of what a human being would be. And we're going to replace that. This will just be an empty void. And we're going to replace that with your head so that you are actually the character in this. Do you have any comments or questions? Any kind of like suggestions?
He's supposed to have these little gross legs that are just kind of stuck on, that are awkward and weird.
No, I can totally do it. I'll do the same thing I did with the Sculpey arms, is I'll find a place here and make really weird, like, you know, atrophied.
Yeah, atrophied is definitely.
Just completely reverse genetics, like if they're disappearing now and it's evolving to something else.
Yeah.
So those will be disappearing. But yeah, that'd be a really weird, creepy, fun addition.
Well, it's really interesting, like in the books, there's this one scene where every time someone comes and sees him for the first time, like they're always like looking at him, and they're always like trying to find like where his junk would be, you know?
Oh, really?
And he's like, it's gone by then though. It's like, at this point, it's completely gone, but he's like, muses to himself about like, maybe I should just like put some fake appendage on there just to like gross people out. Yeah, like he thinks to himself like, I should just put one on there just to fucking, they're looking for it, I'll give them something to look at. You know?
I'm actually just the hired hand here. You're the producer of this. If you want some junk on here, and some slightly strange breasts.
Tyson's definitely convinced me of having the gross, saggy boobs.
Yeah, not
thanks,
quite,
Tyson.
Not
That's
quite the witchy, knuckle bonesy.
Gross. Not like socks, but a little sag. But they're not saggy, you know. Just want to put that on record. All right, Tim, we're working on our worm, God Emperor of Dune. Tell me where we're at right now.
So these little appendages are what's left of your character's legs over the years of atrophy.
Oh, wow, those look great.
Weirdness.
Oh, yeah, I love the little gimpy one. Yeah. Oh, that's so good.
Different sizes, like one's just starting to wither away, probably just drop out pretty soon.
Yeah, that's awesome. That's perfect. I like all the scritchy, scratchy patterns, you know, like he's been moving around on sand and it's all...
Yeah, the texture I decided to go with was very kind of dry.
These segments look so good. Cool. Love it. What kind of colors are we thinking for the paint job? What do you have in mind?
I think, you know, typically I think what people would expect to see on the back of this is probably the same kind of stuff that we saw in the film. Like mm-hmm. a very dry, kind of bland, worm type, you know, paint scheme. But on the inside, where your head sockets into, all this weird fleshiness and all mm-hmm. this chest plate and legs can be a little bit more, I think, vibrant, kind of like the inside of the mouth.
Now, Dune is the best-selling science fiction novel of all time, but when Frank Herbert was trying to get it published, he was turned down by like 20 publishers or more, and instead he ended up getting published by Chilton Books for the first edition, and Chilton was known for publishing auto repair manuals. So an auto repair manual publisher we took a chance on Frank Herbert and Dune, and I really want one of those Chilton books. They're like $5,000 to get one. It's like crazy. It's like really expensive. But yeah, it's amazing.
The original printing?
Yes, the original Chilton printing. I know someone who has one. I was really jealous.
Oh.
Here is our Leto II Dune worm body.
Oh my goodness.
Basically, I just stole a bunch of sand from my kid's park and got a spaghetti strainer, and I'm sifting all the sand around the worm to kind of give it the look that it's in the desert.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm building up sort of mounds here, so it's not just completely flat. Yeah.
This is what we're doing today. How's it looking?
Oh, yeah.
Today we're on to phase two of our Dune Worm shoot. Previously we shot a miniature maquette sculpted by Tim Martin. And today we have Mike Spatola, who has created our facial look, and he's applying right now. He's of the Cinema Makeup School. Mike Spatola is the author of the Monstrous Makeup Manual, where you can learn how to do some really cool practical effects in there if you're interested. I think this is going to be my sexiest look. It's going to bring all the boys to my sand dune, inspire some really confused feelings. So Mike, how long have you been working in the practical effects industry?
I started working when I was about 15, so 37 years.
Now you're working at the Cinema Makeup School.
Yep.
Over there. And you've also published two books now.
About 5 years ago, I wrote a book called The Monstrous Makeup Manual. I always wanted to write a book sort of as a tribute to the Dick Smith Monster Makeup Handbook. And so I wrote the book. It did really well. So I did a second, which did even better. And that came out earlier this year. And I'm working on a third now. It's all about everything A to Z as far as kind of special makeup, character makeup, and monsters.
Mm-hmm. And is that what you like to specialize in?
Yeah, I love monsters. They're the most fun.
I feel like a thumb.
You look like CeeLo.
So I'm feeling really hot right now, feeling my ultimate most hottest. I think that this is going to be the weirdest thing by far in the calendar, so it probably will end up being my favorite. And when I showed my uncle Daniel this, who got me into Dune in the first place, he was like, He almost died. He was laughing so hard. So glad I could bring a smile at least to my uncle's face. He never smiles about anything. Just because I'm a worm doesn't mean I don't want to look hot, all right? I still put on my makeup in there every morning. Just do the best I can with what I got. So originally when we conceived doing Leto II, we were a little overly ambitious and we wanted to like build a full suit. out of cardboard and things like that, but we decided that that was a bit too much. That was going to be a bit too much. So Mike Spatola actually had the idea of making a maquette, a shorter, smaller version, and then making a face makeup separate. So then we had Tim Martin do the sculpture for the worm body, and then Mike is obviously doing the face. So then we're going to composite them together in Photoshop, and it's going to look super awesome. All right, I'm ready to go to the Olive Garden now. Ready for my date. We should put this on my, get a Tinder account and put this on my fucking icon. What's up, fellas? Ready to mingle.
Here we go. Nice. Yes. All right, your worm, your sexy worm. Loving it. Good.
Yeah, baby.
Been in the desert for thousands of years and finally you've emerged.
Fuck. That's good. Regal. Yeah, do it. That's good. Yeah, that's it. That comes apart. That's it. They can.
Okay, now you're sexy. You're sexy. Pucker those lips. You're mouth. You're the cover of Victoria's Secret. 2,000 years in the future. All right, now fashion. Fashion.
Okay, that's a wrap.
So how long did it take to apply this makeup today?
I would say about 90 minutes. I wasn't timing it, but that's what it seemed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it didn't seem too long. Not like the Venom makeup that took like 4 hours. This was a little less intense.
Well, it wasn't your whole body, so.
That helps. My sister said that I look like a penis, so I sent her a picture, selfie. She was very confused, but I made her smile. So for all of you out there, if you want to see more of Mike Spatola's work, you can check it out at
monstrousmakeupmanual.com.
I think you did a fantastic job today, Mike. Thank you so much for turning me into the Dune Worm. I just can't wait to see how this turns out.
This should be fun.
With your work and Tim Martin's work combined together, it'll make the weirdest month for our entire calendar. Be on the lookout for the calendar. It'll be going on sale at the end of November, maybe beginning of December. Stay tuned. Friend us on Facebook, and you'll know all the details. I need that pizza. We got to hurry this up. All right. I've eaten a bagel today, and that's it.
Hold on.
Mm-hmm.